It's that time of year again, ladies and gentlemen. My Unseen Legions, the annual conference of diverse literary wizards. Each spring, they gather to debate which creator best captured the essence of mages and grandmasters. They argue and quarrel, and occasionally duel with wands, swords, or lightsabers. Lately, they've taken to chanting poems that contain names of hidden characters from their mythos. And this enchants we mere mortals to also speak in rhyme. I feel the spell gathering even now. Wow. But nothing is ever resolved. Only one thing is for certain. Each year they leave a bigger mess, I guess. Now heed me carefully. As the wizards speak, they will say names and phrases that sound like characters from their tales and others. The one clever listener among you who marks on your sheet closest to the total number of fictional names shall win the Grandmaster Prize at the end of the evening. When this play is complete, put your name and estimate on your sheet and pass it to the aisle. I believe I hear some early arrivals. Let's watch.
Sorry, man, for my grand elf sin. Peeked through my keyhole and saw in. Ere he gone grocery bagging's regal, you say Gollum, I say Smeagol.
Weightlifting by my dumbbell door, from Maryland near Baltimore. My Harry Potter's wheel is measly. My Hagrid haggis tastes quite weasley. If my love good calls me loony, hurts not my heart, tell her my knee.
The boy wizard's father, and Gandalf's the man. And now, on their heels, Jedi Obi-Wan.
I tramp solo and chew Chewbacca. I Leia, but he walks. Yes, he's a Skywalker. We are two hearts, just jobbing later. They ought to Aunt Lando like an invader.
By the great lords, are you two ever silent?
The Emperor Rowling would be angered and violent if I ever quieted for such as you.
What say you, old man? You believe this is true?
For the sake of King Lucas, and now Disney his prince, let's not fight until we've eaten.
I could use a mince.
It's always this way, as long as they're munching. On buffet crudité and snacking and crunching. On cheesecake and canapé, these folks aren't so grim. But wait, who is this? I've never seen him.
Are you the great Led Zeppelin IV tarot druid?
No, I'm a wizard of Earthsea, or some other fluid.
How dare you come here without an invite?
When one sees a misdeed, one must set it right. Hands away from your weapons. Allow me to talk. In my archipelago, I'm called Sparrowhawk. Forgive my appearance, my tone, and my nagging. 2 hours ago, I was slaying a dragon. I was famous before some of you were well known, so I resent your arrogant snobbery and tone. Only wizards well hyped to your conference may go. But that practice is ending right now.
Is that so?
Do you wish to duel Merlin? He's coming, you know. Plus that mage from the Tempest, the Duke, Prospero. And Jafar from Aladdin's attending because, as of late, he's been dating good Glinda of Oz. Baba Yaga's attending to keep things in focus. Plus those Sanderson sisters from that flick, Hocus Pocus. And don't you dare let this convention begin, lacking the wizards of Ursa Le Guin. And to make sure that this party's not stuffy, I've invited Doc Strange and Miss Willow from Buffy.
I should cry, none shall pass. What would I truly mean, none?
And Avada Kedavra wouldn't be any fun.
And I guess that the force is within everyone.
Though you enter bedraggled.
And dress like a bum.
Your point is well taken. We say,
let them come.
This year's Wizard Conference saw goodwill throughout. 1,000 attended, of that I've no doubt. Snobbishness departed, no wizard was snappy, and everyone left feeling perfectly happy. Except me, surrounded by paper and cup, because nobody offered a wand to clean up.
Sandwiches, sleeping bags, matches. We should pack just like a camping trip, right?
How am I supposed to know? It's an enchanted forest, Rachel. I must have missed that episode of Man vs. Wild.
I know. I've just wanted to explore a place like this ever since I was a little girl. I just want to make sure we're prepared.
And we will be. This is our dream, the adventure of a lifetime, exploring a whole new big magical world, just you and me.
Well, funny you should say that.
What did you do?
Hey guys, ready to go?
You invited
Kevin?
Well, hello to you too.
Yes, I invited Kevin. What's that supposed to mean?
Oh, you invited Kevin. You invited your boyfriend on our quest. How fun.
Penny, is everything okay?
Everything is great, so great.
It doesn't sound that way.
No, it's just, why?
Look, I know you guys haven't exactly always gotten along, but Kevin is an Eagle Scout, and he's good with maps, and who knows what kind of huge, dangerous monsters we'll run into once we're there.
And we're gonna use him as bait?
No, he'll protect us.
With what? His Swiss Army knife? This isn't the 1940s, Rachel. We can protect ourselves fine. The heroes of the story always win.
Please, I don't want to leave him behind. I think we could really use his help.
Fine, whatever you say.
We won't regret it, I promise.
Sure.
So I got your voicemail. We're going camping?
Well, almost.
We're almost going camping.
It's hard to explain. Here.
The Legends of the Wintervale. What's this, a kid's book?
That's where we're going.
Excuse me?
We're going to the Wintervale.
Right. Are you feeling okay?
She's not kidding. It's a real place.
Yeah, I guess maybe it can feel that way. Books are transporting and all the stuff the librarian at school tells us, but did I come all the way over here just so you could show me a book? Because I don't think I needed to pack a bag for that.
Kevin, we're really going. We found a way in.
What even is this? An enchanted forest? Castles? Dragons? Wizards? Excuse me for thinking that maybe we're a little far from Middle Earth. Where did you even get this? I've never heard of this book before.
Penny and I were in the library the other day studying for Mr. Frederick's English test. When we got back to my place and I was unpacking all the books I'd checked out, it was in the pile. Neither of us had put it there. The book found us. It wanted to show us the way.
Rachel, babe, you're not making any sense. It must have just slipped into your bag by accident, or maybe it got moved from someone else's pile. Just because you don't remember putting it in the bag doesn't mean it's some magical book from Fantasyland.
Listen, Killjoy, I thought so too, but then we found the writing inside.
Writing?
On every page we turned to, there was this little rhyme written in the margin.
So some punk vandalized the book. Just tell the librarian and she'll order a new copy.
It wasn't just any writing, Kevin. It didn't mean anything until we said it out loud.
He's not getting it, Rach. We should show him.
Show me what?
Let's do it.
You guys are crazy. You're not making any sense.
With open hearts that cannot fail, open the doors to Wintervale.
Oh my gosh. What's happening?
We opened the portal. Look in the closet. Can you see the forest and the castle?
Told you so.
How are you doing that? Make it stop. What just happened?
We opened the door to Wintervale.
Do you believe us now?
I.
Oh, great. He's speechless.
I don't know what to say. There's a door to a magic world inside your closet.
Well, you better figure it out quick. We're leaving now.
Leaving for what?
For Wintervale. Where else?
You mean you actually want to go through that thing?
Of course we do. It's the adventure of a lifetime.
You have no idea what's on the other side.
You said it yourself. Castles, dragons, and wizards. Don't you want to see it all?
No! I mean, I don't think so. Maybe? This is all just a lot to process.
Well, Rach, it sounds like his mind is made up. And what a disappointment that is.
Okay, let's go. Penny, please. Kevin, look. This is all that Penny and I have ever dreamed about as kids. We grew up with Narnia and Oz and Wonderland and Hogwarts and so many more. This is finally our chance to be the heroes of the story like we've always wanted. The book chose us for some special mission or story, and we intend to see it through, no matter what it is. We may be gone for a long time, and you can come with us if you want, but we're leaving. Now.
I don't know, Rachel. Can't you be heroes here? On Earth?
How?
I don't know. There's that history midterm in Mrs. Jones's class. If you pass that, you'll be everyone's hero.
That's not quite the same thing.
I know.
Okay then, well, I guess that's my answer.
No, wait. I'll go.
Really?
Of course. I love you, Rachel. And if this is what you want, then let's go. I'm all for it.
I love you too.
Yay! Kevin is coming! It's definitely a party now!
Okay, so how does this work? You just say the words and the portal opens?
Not quite. You really have to feel the words to get it to work.
How do you do that?
I guess just open your heart.
What does that mean?
I think it means being ready for a new chapter and putting your faith in the story. Can you do that?
I think so.
Then it looks like we're ready to go. Everybody join hands.
With open hearts that cannot fail, open the doors to Wintervale.
What happened? Did we do something wrong?
No, everything was right. I don't know what happened. Penny, did you do something different?
Nope.
Not a thing. Maybe the book
doesn't like him. Maybe it doesn't want him to go with us.
Are you sure the book's the one that doesn't like him?
I don't see any other explanation.
I think I do. Everyone has to have an open heart.
Penny, is everything okay?
Just peachy, Kevin.
Penny, please, tell us what's the matter.
You don't know what the matter is? Really?
Tell me.
Rachel, you're my best friend in the whole world. In all the worlds that secret closet portals lead to, and I'm sure even more than those. Ever since we were 6 years old, this has been our dream. To go off together and explore a fantasy world. Just you and me. And when we finally and inexplicably get to do that, you bring him along. This was supposed to be our special plan. That's always been the deal. And now everything is ruined.
Penny, I had no idea you felt that way.
Well, you never even took the time to ask me. It was bad enough when you started dating because I had to share my best friend, but now I have to share my lifelong dream too. It's not fair.
Penny, I'm sorry if I made you feel like I was taking Rachel away from you or trying to steal away your dreams. I can't come close to the past the two of you have, and I don't want to. I'm sorry.
And I'm sorry too. I should have known how special this was for you, for us. I love you, Penny, and I've been dreaming of this day for as long as I can remember. I guess I didn't realize I had messed it up so badly.
I'd really like us to be friends, and we both love Rachel an awful lot. I'd be honored to go on this adventure with the both of you. What do you say?
I think I'd like that too, on one condition.
Name it.
You at least have to try to slay a dragon once with your Swiss Army knife. I need to prove a point.
Deal.
Look, it's opening, Penny. You opened your heart. Come on, it's an adventure of a lifetime.
How about Thursday the 24th? How does that sound?
That's a little far out. Don't you have anything sooner?
Well, it's a very busy time of the year for us, what with graduation coming up, lots of people coming of age, hitting that moment.
Yes, I understand. But I just don't know what to do with him. He just lies on the couch all day, playing video games, not a single word to me or his father. And when it's time to get him out of school for school, it takes every ounce of energy. And when it comes to homework, oh.
Well, I don't know if that's something we can help with. It doesn't sound like he's ready to be renamed.
How dare you? He is the same age as those two over there, in the same calculus class as you. Boy, what's your name?
Hello, Mrs. Smith.
Ma'am, I'm going to ask you to calm down and lower your voice. Our services here at the Bureau of Renaming are not one size fits all. Age has nothing to do with it. Some people don't get renamed until they're 18, some aren't ready until they're 50. And if he shows up to the appointed time, not ready to be renamed, we'll send him home.
Of course he'll be ready. I'm a very good mother, but I'm at my wit's end.
I'm not questioning your parenting skills, quite the opposite. Your skills and abilities have nothing to do with it. Your son will be ready for renaming precisely when he's no longer dependent on you.
Oh, that's ridiculous. He'll be ready. But how am I going to show him who he's going to be if I don't help him? Every day I tell him, you could be so much more. A doctor? A teacher? Don't you want to have a family, be recognized in the community for help?
Well, the process of renaming is a little more complicated
than... Don't I know that? Why do you think I'm here? Begging for your help.
Look, I can shift some things around and get him in here Wednesday at 3, right after school lets out. Will that work for you?
Yes, yes, of course, that will work. Why couldn't you just say that sooner? I'll have him here.
And we'll send him home. He ain't ready, lady.
Wow, that was pretty intense. People get kind of crazy about this renaming stuff, right?
Well, it makes sense. It's kind of a big deal. It's basically the most important day of your life.
I don't know about that. I mean, I've had some pretty big days already. Like when I led a team to victory for the state championship, and I got chosen to be prom king. You hear about that?
Oh, yes.
And just last week, I picked up a full ride scholarship to state. What's gonna top all that?
I don't know. This just seems different. All of that stuff is terrific, but these new names, they're like our futures. What we're going to be, what we're going to do with our lives.
Whatever you do, as long as you keep looking as good as you do right now, you'll be fine.
Yeah, I took a little extra time this morning getting ready because I knew I'd be seeing you here.
I'm glad you did.
Yeah?
I like looking at you.
Yeah, what do you like?
Well, you're hot, you know.
And
that skirt looks great on you.
Easy now, Tiger.
And?
Excuse me, miss, but you need to settle down.
Nothing else?
Well, I mean, I would, but you know.
Yeah. There was a girl on my squad 2 years ago. She didn't really seem like much, but ever since she got her new name, she's...
Hang on a sec. I've got to reply to this.
Oh, sure.
Oh my gosh. I'm sorry. I'm so late. My rehearsal ran late, so I had to get on the last bus over here. And then I got off the wrong stop, then I had to walk from Juana over here.
And it's fine. It's fine. Just go have a seat. We'll squeeze you right in after these two.
Thank you. Thank you.
Just take a breath, honey.
Hi, guys.
Dude, whatever. You're a mess.
Hi.
Hey, buddy, you going to prom this weekend? Are we going to get a chance to see all your fabulous dance moves? Or do you save those for the school play with all the other queers? Who am I kidding? The only date you're going on with is with your dictionary.
Oh, hey! How was your appointment, Melissa?
Nope. She's got a new name now.
Oh, that's right!
Congratulations.
Well, out with it. Let's hear it. What do you get?
I got forgiven. I'm forgiven.
Wow, that's sort of cool.
Forgiven for what? That's a load of...
That's wonderful, honey. I'm so happy for you. How does it feel?
Different, but good, I think.
Give it some time. Try it on for size. Let your new name settle. You'll soon see how well you can live into it. You'll be surprised.
Yeah. All right. Thank you. Thank you so much.
You're next, fella.
Well, wish me good luck, everyone. Want to play some bets? What you think I'm going to get? Victor, Braun, Clark Kent. So many good options. I just don't know how they're going to land on just one.
Well, you'll never know unless you get your butt inside that room.
Yes, ma'am.
Good luck.
Hello?
Good afternoon.
Hi there. Where are you?
I'm right here, around you.
Yeah, of course. What a stupid question.
No stupid questions. But that's maybe not the one you're actually here to ask.
You're right.
What do you really want to ask?
Well, that's fairly obvious, right? That's why we're here. What's my new name? I'm ready for it.
Are you? Indeed?
You know it.
Very well, then. Your new name is Tender.
Excuse me? I'm sorry, what?
You will be Tender.
This is a joke, right? Good one. Really funny. But you've got a full waiting room out there, so we probably shouldn't be wasting any more time.
You're right. We are done here. You may go.
Dude, are you for real? This is crap. Tender? Tender? That's the softest name I've ever heard. How am I gonna show my face with that? Do you know what I am? What I do? What I'm supposed to be?
Better than you know. You're bold, you're brave, you're courageous and unafraid. But you've only begun to tap into the strength that lies within you. It's time to start building up the greatest muscle I've placed in you, your heart. There's so much good you're going to do in the road once you learn that.
What? Are you for real? This is not even what I expected.
There's no mistake.
Can you maybe double check your records and see if there's a mistake?
There's no mistake.
Are you sure? Please?
I'm sure. And you'll be wonderful with it. Goodbye.
Hello? Are you there? Okay, I guess that's it.
My, what was that all about?
He'll be fine. More than fine.
Are you sure? If he didn't get a good new name, what hope do the rest of us have?
I'm not sure that's what
this is. Oh, this is so not good. Maybe I shouldn't do this? Is it possible to cancel my appointment? I'd be happy to come back in a couple of weeks, study up a bit for whatever we're going to be asked, to lose a couple pounds, and...
You're gonna do just fine, honey. And it's your turn right now.
I knew I shouldn't have done this. I only came here because every other girl in the squad did, and they all came back so happy, so radiant, so ready for life, but I'm me. That'll never happen. I can only fake it for so long before someone always finds out that
hey.
I'm...
Good job yesterday on your speech for comm class. I thought it was really funny, and, well, I didn't know that you knew all that stuff about animals. I mean, dogs kind of freak me out, but you made them seem not so scary. If you want to be a veterinarian, like you said in your speech, you did say that, right? Well, I mean, if you did, I think you'd be great. Maybe that'll be your name. Good luck.
Oh, thanks. Thanks a lot. Hello?
Hello there.
Oh, wow. Trippy.
I'm glad to see you.
Well, I'm glad to be here, I think.
Well, you made the appointment, my dear. Do you want to be here?
I think so, but I'm not sure I'm supposed to be. Am I?
You are. And that's your question, yes? You are enough.
I am?
Yes, you've always been, and you always will be. So I give you that name as a reminder. You are enough. Not because of what you do and how you will succeed, and you will, but just because of who you are. You are enough.
Oh, thank you. I hope that I'll work hard enough and be able to earn the...
Shh. Enough.
Yes. I'll try to... I'll remember. Thank you. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
I appreciate you insisting that I keep the appointment.
Most of the time, they do.
Hey, good luck in there.
Thanks.
Well, honey, you're the last one of the day. I told you I'd fit you in, didn't I?
You did.
You ready for this?
As much as I'm ever going to be. Here goes nothing. If I die or something, could you please call my mom and let her know that my brother is under no circumstances to touch my comic book collection?
I'm on it.
Thanks. How do you do? Anybody home?
Hello there. I've been waiting for you for quite some time. Forever, in fact. Good to see you, beloved.
I wish you would get started with our training already. There's only so many herbs and flowers I can pick over.
I'm not sure you should be bothering those plants at all. Did she say it was all right?
She didn't say it wasn't all right.
I can't stand hanging out here in the middle of nowhere, waiting on some weird old woman to finally sit down and start our training.
She's not that weird. Or that old.
And anyhow, Emor, do you have someplace better to be?
Yeah, anywhere but here. Since when did they let women become wizards anyhow?
Since always. If you would prefer not to receive your training at all, I can arrange for your travels home.
I'll stay.
Good. We're glad to have you, so long as you're glad to be here. And are you two ready?
Yes, Genova.
Wonderful. Then we'll get started with today's lesson. Patience is vital to a wizard. It is a special kind of power. There are, in fact, many forms of power.
Yeah, and I wonder if we'll ever learn about any of them.
Would you rather I stop our lesson for the day, or stop our lessons for good? Is that your preference, Emor?
My preference is to learn.
Then perhaps you should try to do that. As I was saying, there are many forms of power. Each is useful in its own ways. Each can be destructive, too. There must be balance. Day and night, chaos and stability. This is the only way that true power can be attained, by understanding the equilibrium of the universe.
And if you don't understand the balance, what then?
Then you put yourself, and perhaps others, in danger.
How? How could you be in danger?
An imbalanced power can be corrupting. It can seep into you like poison. It can lead you away from your calling.
Yeah, I'm sure it can. This doesn't sound like a lesson. It sounds more like a warning. Something to scare us away from magic altogether.
Perhaps the best lessons in life should scare you. That is, if you're listening to them correctly. That's enough for today. Come in now for supper. That's one thing we should all be able to agree on.
That book.
What about it?
We need to get it from her.
Why?
What do you mean, why? So we can learn all her secrets, of course.
I don't think we should do this.
Why did you invite her anyways?
I figured we might all learn something from this book.
I think I understand.
Understand what?
Everything.
That quick, huh?
It's better than staying here and learning from that old lady.
And what is it that you learned?
That everything we need to know is right over there. She's kept us on this side because she doesn't want us to know her secrets. Well, she can't keep them from me now.
Don't!
Just stay back and be quiet for a little while until we're out of sight. Can you do that for us?
Us? There's no us in this. I'm not going with you.
What? Are you too afraid to go any further?
I'm not afraid. I'm just not a fool like you.
Whatever you say.
We should do something.
Let him go. If that's what he wants, who are we to stop him?
But Wenda, we don't know what's out there.
Perhaps not, but that's for him to find out for himself.
And where is Emor?
Not here.
It's been all night, and he hasn't come back yet.
Come back? Where did he go?
He wandered off.
In that direction, I presume? I feared this might happen. Some young wizards have no patience at all.
Now what? Should we go after him? Form a search party, maybe? Are there any other wizards who could help us?
Perhaps he'll come back on his own.
I doubt that.
As do I, but one can hope.
And if he doesn't come back on his own?
Then it's his choice. Not all who ramble into the shadows return. It's the natural way of things.
But that isn't fair. It's entirely fair, Cece. It was his choice.
As I told you already, power is balance, and we each choose our own path.
But you're supposed to guide us. You're a teacher, aren't you?
I can show you the way, but I can't make you do as I do. Your strengths and weaknesses are your own. I can't change that.
Shouldn't we tell her to get away from there? That she too could get lost being so close to the shadows?
You don't have to worry about her. She knows not to wander too far. She knows that you need both light and dark, that one isn't better than the other. Wenda isn't impetuous like Emor, but she isn't fearful of the shadows like you are.
So that's it. Wenda understands the balance of power, and I don't?
It's not that simple. She has balance now, but like any of us, she could lose it. Equilibrium is promised to no one, and we can lose it in an instant. That's why you're here, to learn how to use your powers, to steady yourselves. That's what I can do my best to teach you.